Well, Mrs. Reno, the major focus of today's hearing is the decision-making process at the highest levels of law enforcement community, which led to the actions involving the Branch Davidian cult. Could you describe for the committee the major considerations you personally brought to bear in approving the actions leading up to and including the April 19th operation?
The prime concern that I ask is the question I kept asking over and over again, Mr. Chairman, why now? Why not wait? I reviewed statements that he had made about apocalypse at any time. He could have done this at any time. The FBI advised me that they were in better control considering the state of readiness of their HRT team, so that was a definite factor. I reviewed it was important, and we spent a lot of time determining the water supply. I thought that might be a way, if the water supply were reduced, that we might be able to force them out. And again, we went back through trying to observe the level of water in the tanks to see if it might be possible to wait them out in that fashion. It appeared from everything that we were told, based on our discussion with the negotiator on the scene, who advised that negotiations had reached an impasse, that he was going to stay there and he would not come out voluntarily, and it was going to be an indefinite stay that would expose the lives of agents on the perimeter to danger, would threaten the continued safety of all inside. I continued to be concerned about the children. There was no sanitary facility for them. They were dumping their waste. The conditions were increasing in that regard. We had had reports, and as I have pointed out, until you see the children, you cannot confirm the reports one way or the other about the abuse of the children. But the concern I had was that to let this go on indefinitely, where you had dangerous offenders who had killed 4 agents, injured 16 others, was something that could best be resolved by increasing the pressure, not to make this D-Day, but to try to increase the pressure by the use of gas, which I had determined by, after very careful review, would not be permanently harmful to the children. By tear gassing the compound, that would be the best way to proceed to increase the pressure to try to force them out.
Now, Mr.